Hello! What's up, guys? It has been a hot minute. Everyone says that. Every single YouTuber says that, but it actually has been. I have not uploaded something in months, and that's because I have nothing to post about, because every day is kind of the same thing, except now I'm doing school. So, I thought I would just get ready and talk to you guys about what has been happening since I last saw you, or since you last saw me, because I never see you guys. So, although I do read your comments, and a lot of them brighten up my day, just like reading them and seeing what you guys are up to and how my videos kind of, I actually don't know if they affect you in any way, but it's nice to hear what you guys have to say. Okay, so what has been going on? Let's start with October, because a lot of things happened in October. Obviously, I do not have braces anymore, which is a big thing. I got my braces off a few days before my birthday, and yes, now I have retainers in. Okay, so I've been braces free for more than a month. Loving every second. Let me tell you the story. So I got my braces off and I did the dig thing. And that was on October 10, I think. It was a few days before my birthday. And then after we went to the dentist, we got pizza.
Hello.
Hello.
What did you order?
We ordered a pizza.
Mm-hmm. Yummy. My favorite, the marks.
And my mom was like, okay, we're just gonna pick up food for dinner from this place that was not aware of, you know. So we pull up to this house and I'm like, okay, that's cool. I was on my phone, I was like reading, I was texting Dennis, I think. And then all of a sudden, I see Stacy. That was cool. I was really surprised. I did not expect it. No hugging, no touching. I just got to talk to her and she gave me cookies that she baked for my birthday. And then we filmed a few things. We took a couple pictures, but then that was it. I sat off. In my head, I was like, okay. I was seeing where we were going. It was kind of familiar. I kept checking Snapchat, though my phone was about to die because I had been using it the whole day. I kept checking Snapchat. I was like, okay, where are we now? Where are we now? And I saw that we were along that area of the zone. And then I was like, oh, okay. I had a feeling we were going to Venice's house because the area was very familiar to me. But then I didn't want to assume. I didn't want to be like, oh, you're taking me to Venice, no. So then we get to this place where it's like you go down. It's like a hill and you go down and then there are trees there. And I was like, okay, we're going to Venice's house. Because the trees are so familiar, and I had gone to Venice's house before. I just knew that thing was gonna lead to Venice's house. And then we approached her village, and I was like, oh my god! And then I saw Venice. No hugging, no nothing, except for like elbow touches. Like, you know, the elbow, like, I don't know how to describe it. We did that. We filmed a little thing. We didn't really film, we just like recorded ourselves and. Anyway, so I saw Venice and then we were off, and then at that point I kind of was like, okay, so we're seeing my friends. I know where my friends live, and so in my head I knew that we were gonna go to Gabby next. Also, no touching, although there I did vlog.
Hey vlog.
Hey vlog.
Oh my gosh, Yo, wait, I'm actually kind of scared. What are we doing?
Wait. I can connect to their Wi-Fi here.
We'll just say hi.
We're just gonna say hi, guys.
Honestly, I can just ask him to look out the window.
That's his room. Sure. That one?
Yeah.
Penny, nickel, dime. Penny, nickel.
I can hold it.
Wait, don't this thing get
sewer?
Follow him, Paul. If it's okay, follow him.
Wait, I get awkward, okay.
Get awkward? Bro.
Get awkward. Why is this like, he's getting his slippers. But he's getting his chinelas.
He's so bad.
Because his house is so big.
So touch it.
Ow.
Is it an
no, it's not an no. I have an no.
Bravo! What? Oh!
Are you gonna say anything?
Say hi. Thank you. We just want to say hi, like nothing to, just hi while I'm here.
Will your mom allow it?
Will your mom allow it?
But I'm already here, so it's just one. It's kind of far.
Hey guys, I'm Meg's boyfriend for the day. You know those like dramas where they hold the umbrella for your girls?
Oh wait, I feel bad like now. I feel bad now. I also feel like we're really loud.
We actually are, but it's okay. I don't
think
I'm gonna
hide it
anymore.
I feel
so bad. Yeah, I feel so bad for you.
Why didn't you see it? Like,
enough. I don't know what they're talking about. Hey guys! No, just like say hi. We just wanted to say hi. I'm filming, if that's okay. Okay, bye!
Bye!
And I have a couple friends where Gabby lives, so I said hi to them as well from a distance. And then we were off. And then I knew, obviously, I have to visit Chloe because Chloe and I live one road away. We live so near. And so I was like, okay, time to visit Chloe. No touching. It was very hard because obviously you kind of have the urge to hug your friends and stuff. Well, then that's selfish. I'm so thankful I finally got to see my friends. You know, it's been months and I know other people have not seen their friends in a long time. So I'm very thankful that I got to see my friends, and I'm very thankful that they're all okay, you know, they're safe, they're healthy. If you see your friends, minimize the hugging, minimize the touching, even though it's hard. Yes. And that was kind of like my birthday surprise. And then it was my birthday, I turned 15, my hair was like really long. I have pictures from it because I felt really freaking pretty on that day. I also started reading Harry Potter. My tita gave me the books as my birthday gift. I was really happy because I had wanted to read the books, but I was just scared of how to get the books. And then she gave me them for my birthday and I was very happy. I am on Prisoner of Azkaban right now. I haven't read much of the book yet because I'm also currently watching Grey's Anatomy. I started watching Grey's Anatomy and it has made me cry so much. I'm on season 10. It's like every single last episode I cry, and then sometimes I'll cry in the in-between episodes. I have a booger and no one told me. And then obviously I cut my hair a few days after my birthday. My hair was so long, it felt so heavy, and I've been wanting to cut my hair. Then finally, after my birthday, while my parents were watching Emily in Paris, I went to the bathroom, cut my hair, and then my sister helped me out. She helped me even it at the back. Sorry, I don't know how to talk and do mascara. Okay, anyway. So over the course of October, I have gotten my braces removed and I've cut my hair. And that is my quarantine glow up. It stops there. That's not all that's happened. There's a lot of things that happened in between, but those are kind of just big moments that I want to share with you guys. Obviously, I've been redecorating my room. I don't know how long some of you have been here, but my room used to be very like pink, glamour, princess, and I've just kind of been redecorating and rearranging, and my room just feels so much nicer now. I don't know, it feels bigger. It feels more me. I'll show you my room in a second, okay. Oh, I also got blue light glasses because everything is online now. It's just helpful. Even though blue light a lot of the times isn't the real cause of eye problems, a lot of times it's strain. So if you're looking at your phone for a long time, remember to blink, because when you don't blink, that strains your eyes, and oftentimes we forget to blink when we're staring at a screen for so long. So blink. Okay, although these do help when I feel like it's weight. Yeah, Gabby gave me this lip gloss and I love it. I've been using it almost every day. Like whenever I do my makeup, I've been using this. It's so nice. I love my hair. Okay, it's really great. I love the length. I cut it myself with my sister's help. It's really great. Let me show you my room because it's really nice at this time of the day. So obviously I am on TikTok a lot. So I have the vines. So as you can see, my curtains are more flowy now. And look at that. I don't know what. That just looks really pretty to me. The curtains also give me this thingy for when I want to take pictures, when I feel pretty, and then they kind of cast light. Very nice. My mom gave me her plant because she is a plant mom now, and she's been collecting plants, and this was one of her plants and I liked it, and she gave it to me for my birthday. Yeah, so this is my room. Yeah, really airy. My sister and I like to hang out here a lot. This is where we kind of just stay. I also rearranged my closet, gave away a lot of my old clothes that didn't fit me anymore, and yeah. Okay, I have nothing else to say. I actually have a lot to say, but I don't know if I want to. I have this wall, oops, there. I kind of, whatever I paint, I put there, and I've been wanting to paint some more. So let me know if you want me to do a video. I can like answer questions while I paint. Heavily inspired by Verena. I love watching her videos because they just feel like I'm her friend. So those are the updates about me. I am currently in school, grade 10. I took up fine arts as my elective, so that's like my focus for grade 10 in terms of like minor subjects. I'm doing well so far. I'm very lucky that I work well even under these circumstances. And I say that while understanding that not everyone has access to the things I have access to, and that not everyone has been able to work as well as they can during these times. So let's all work together. Come on guys, please don't go to parties. Christmas is coming up. I know it's sad, but let's have our own little Christmases in our homes with the people that we can see, like our immediate family, because the sooner that all this is over with and the sooner that we get to control everything, you know, the sooner people can start going back to school and people can start seeing their friends again, because it's really hard that everything is online, especially since not everyone can be online. It's just hard, okay? It's not, it doesn't level out the playing field, if that makes sense. So let's do what we can so that we can slowly bring everything back to normal. There are a lot of things going on in our country, my country specifically, the Philippines, and there's a bunch of other things happening around the world. So stay informed, get educated, please think before you speak online. I know sometimes you can get very passionate about a subject. I have gotten very passionate over something that I should have thought about some more. Because in order for you to get a point across, you need to have a well thought out and well researched answer. That's my little tip for you. So stay educated, stay informed, speak up against racism and offensive jokes. Jokes are meant to be funny. Please don't joke about bad things. Like I said, I've been wanting to paint, so if you want me to do a painting video... Actually, you know what? I want to paint, so I will paint eventually. But if you want me to film it and maybe like answer questions, I can do that too. I'm just thinking of what I want to paint. I have not thought of like a definite thing that I want to paint yet. I have so many things I want to talk about. I want to talk about where I'm going for senior high school and about my existential crisis, if I'm allowed to say it. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that. Like, I've been having a lot of thoughts regarding my existence recently. I always have lots of thoughts about everything. My brain is just always kind of like questioning everything in a good way. I think in a good way. My friends kind of know about that. I really don't know what this video is. This video is just kind of catching up. It's kind of like a big brain vomit of things that have happened over the past few years, past few months, and kind of what I've been doing and what I've been thinking. I genuinely hope that whoever's watching this right now, like, I genuinely hope you're okay. It's normal to not be motivated right now. It's normal to not be okay, but if my videos help you in any way, I'm glad that they do. And I'll try my best to post more often because I enjoy it, and it's kind of my safe place. So that's all, and I will see you whenever I have the urge to film again. Okay, bye.